The clock is ticking down for the heroes of the DC Universe. Can they cure the anti-life plague, or will they all be destroyed before they get the chance? Let's hop into the pages of DC's Dead Planet issue number 7, the grand finale, and find out together, shall we? So then, as we hop into the book proper, the Amazo army is spreading across the planet, destroying every zombie in its wake. These terrifying death machines were built to do battle with the Justice League in their prime, and indeed they will be coming up against a Justice League, but a very different incarnation than the one they're used to. One imbued with new and different powers, incredibly dangerous weapons, but still that same drive to save the world from the forces of evil. Now, if the robot kill squads weren't enough for the people of Earth, there's still the little matter of Demon Lord coming to Earth to reap all the dead souls that he's been denied. Zatanna and the Phantom Stranger head on off to deal with Big Nasty Red over here, and we're reminded that the Phantom Stranger is actually acting against character here, what with the actually getting involved thing. It would seem that when the chips are down and everything is on the line, not even the Stranger can be a stranger to humanity anymore. Now, while these climactic battles are being fought, John and Damian, the respective new Superman and Batman, head to Australia, and of course Tom Taylor had to work in Australia for the big finale of his story. Can't blame the man. The Super Sons, turned world's finest, have to get inside the Penguin's base of operation and dismantle the Amazo droids at the source of their power. Of course, naturally, an entire fortress built on the back of mob bosses, one percenters, and criminal CEOs are ready for such an occasion. Their flunkies have been equipped with brand new kryptonite rounds, but here's the rub though, when they're ordered to fire on the heroes, none of them do it. They forsake their paymasters for the greater good, showing that even in the darkest hours, there is still good inside humanity that is worth fighting for. It's also around here too that John Constantine makes his appearance known. John has basically been working on what is the biggest, nastiest magical con game in all of human history, and for the next phase of his plan to work, he needs to reap the souls of Penguin, Ivo, and the other bad guys. Unfortunately, Dr. Ivo was already dead by the time Superman and Batman got there, meaning shutting down the Amazo droids just got a little bit more difficult. Luckily, the good guys still have Elite Hacksaw in the form of Cyborg, who they hope can crack one of the heads of these Amazos wide open and figure out the best way to turn them all off before they kill everyone. While the tech work is being done, Superman and Wallace West Kid Flash are gonna travel all around the world to try and dispense as much of the cure as humanly possible. After all, the Amazo droids are only programmed to kill zombies, meaning for every person that they cure, they end up saving a life not once, but twice over. But for this humanitarian effort to work, it means Constantine is finally gonna have to go toe-to-toe with Trigon. The Demon Lord is of course very confident, talking about the millions of years worth of torment that await Constantine in the pit and all the different enemies he's made over the years who can't wait to get a crack at him. But John's gonna get a couple cracks in first before they get the chance. After all, he's gathered together some of the most powerful artifacts and magical forces that the DC Universe has to offer, meaning he hits with the strength of Hercules. The arcane knowledge of Dr. Fate, the cloak of Ragman, the Spear of Destiny, and so much more. For a second there, it actually looks like Constantine might be able to win the day on his own, but unfortunately, he's still very squishy and very human. Constantine is killed, which in turn causes John Kent the Superman to go to avenge him, and normally a Superman would be pretty weak to magical forces, but here John is spurred on like never before to beat down Big Red. But this is the Hellblazer we're talking about here, and John Constantine always has one last card up his sleeve, in this case, the whole reason that he killed Boston Brand and stole the power of the dead man. You see, much like Obi-Wan Kenobi before him, John Constantine is more powerful in death than he ever was in life. In fact, he may be the most powerful ghost who ever lived, or unlived, depending on how you look at it. And despite a career filled with putting himself over other people and sacrificing others along the way, John Constantine, right here and now at the end of the world, makes the ultimate sacrifice of himself. John jumps into the body of Trigon and is able to manipulate him to commit Spear of Destiny Seppuku. This has a twofold effect. It vanquishes the demon lord that is Trigon, but it also ends up destroying John's own soul in the process, which means he's not going to make it to heaven, but also that he won't be tortured in hell. A fate that may very well seem sad from the outside, but as far as John is concerned, this is the best result that he could have asked for, even if it means leaving his beloved Zatanna behind. It's right around here too, the Amazos ultimately get shut down, which means the Justice League is able to make their rounds all over the Earth, curing people of the anti-life plague, including some of their closest friends and allies. The comic even ends in a very sweet, understated little reunion between Dinah and Ollie, who can finally get married like they wanted to. And so, that was DC's Dead Planet issue number 7, everybody. Not only a pretty damn solid conclusion to this newest zombie epic from Tom Taylor, but a pretty good finale for the three-parter that was Deceased. Even though there was a lot of characters and everyone kind of got their moment across all of Dead Planet, I think this will ultimately go down as one of the better John Constantine stories in the bigger DC non-Vertigo universe. I've said it before, but it bears repeating. I think what we truly enjoy about zombie fiction and why we keep coming back to it is because all of these end-of-the-world loss-of-humanity stories are also show-what-you're-made-of type of stories. And in the end, a morally gray character like John had a lot to show, and he did. Overall, I'd feel very comfortable giving this one a 9 out of 10. If you've been trade waiting on this final part of Deceased, or if you haven't read the series before, there's no better time to hop on in than right now.
Hey there everyone, it's your old pal Cape Jewel again, thanking you so much for watching to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, why not check out my Amazon link down in the description? Yes, that's right, the Cape Jewel channel officially has its own Amazon storefront now. You can pick up a comic, or anything else for that matter, and if you did, you'd really be helping me and the channel. So with that out of the way everyone, I will see you again next time. Bye-bye.